Hello, Sula here from MistyHilltops.com. Thanks for stopping by. In this video, I'm working on a 6x12 scrapbook double page spread titled Walk the Sights, and I'll be scrapping a number of photos, and I'm working with a digital scrapbook kit, Sunny Cerulean Zephyr by Crystal Hartley from Sweet Shop Designs. I'm also using stamps and dies, among them a die cut set from Chapter 3 by Tim Holtz. So I have prepared this in my Silhouette Studio software, where I set up the page and then I just print and then cut things out. And then I run a card along the edges just to roughen up the edges so that they can be give a little more contrast and dimension to the page. And then I'm ready to start to glue things down. And here I'm starting with a paper strip, and it's the background strip, so I don't want to put the paper strip there that goes first. And because it takes me a little while to start with the first page, I kind of want to make sure it's centered in the center of the page. And so I had to reapply the adhesive there to make sure it still sticks. The glue is fast drying. But I think the second time around, no, it's still giving me a little bit of trouble there. But I think this time I'm actually getting it to where it is ready to stick down. And then it's just the first page is a little tricky, the first half of the spread. The other half I can use this page as a guideline, but to get things started is always the most tricky part for me. And so once I have this one down, then see, this one didn't take as long, and then I can put down this paper strip. But I'm not actually gluing that one down, because there will be things layered behind that strip, and for once I was remembering it. I think often I forget that something still needs to be tucked behind, and then I glue it down and it's almost impossible to remove it from the page and be able to tuck things behind. So this might happen even on this very page perhaps, but for the most part I try to be aware of the ordering of the layering. So here again, I'm starting with this strip there, but it doesn't matter on which side it goes, so obviously I'm starting with this side here. They're both identical, because it's basically a 12x12 kit that I reduced to a 6x6, so it's a full scrapbook page, and so it's basically identical whichever way you look at it. And so it doesn't matter on which side of the page it goes. And then here I can start with aligning with the two pages. It's easy then to put it down. But here I was mindful, you see there, that circle is supposed to go behind, tucked behind that gray polka dot pattern paper there. So I needed to make sure that I didn't put too much glue on that side there behind, so I can still tuck it. And I think I did, I really considered it, so it wasn't an oversight. And then I make sure to still apply some glue, and I use a toothpick for that, so that I can apply glue behind that strip of paper so it can still fully be glued down. Then I have this large circle, and that will go across the two pages, and I'm still trying to figure out, I don't think it is really directional, it doesn't matter, but I am a little picky, I guess, this way, and I wanted it to be the way that I had it on in my Silhouette file there. So I have my computer nearby that where I can reference the original sketch, I guess. Well, it's just a file that I create in the Silhouette Studio, where I then clip the papers to, and then I keep that page, that canvas open, so that I can reference and see how was the original design meant to be. And so it helps me with clipping the papers to things, and then I put them in a different file to print them, so on a different canvas to spread them out and print them, and then I am ready to cut them out, and then I I can still reference the original canvas to see how the page was supposed to come together, because trust me, by the time I have everything printed, I forgot most of the design of that page, and so I like to be to keep that little reminder there. So here I'm gluing down the photos, and these are pretty tiny photos actually. Like I said, it's a 6x6 double page, so it's 12x6 size, and so like the photos have to be small. And I'm making sure, because I have glued the circle, I'm making sure with this paper strip going across the page where the middle line is, so that I can glue the line the photos. You see, I keep coming back to putting that paper strip there to make sure it really aligns with the cut line, because I will cut these two pages apart again for the way that it'll go in a mini book. I haven't really decided yet. So far, I have only created just page by page. I started this album years ago, and I kind of regret I started gluing them together. This time I would just consider just creating a 6x6 mini album and then just adhering those pages to that album. But I wasn't thinking that way when I started it. I started it as before I even had my silhouette, so obviously I couldn't have known what I was that I was still 10 years later or something. I'm still working on this album. So, but I've been having a lot of fun with this. So here you see me, I am clustering, and there's flowers. So what I did is when I printed, I always have a little bit of space on my papers that I use for printing. And so I just created some smaller rectangles of just solid color. Sometimes I even use just the solid colors, colored papers from the kit. And then I use them to stamp and cut flowers, like use my dies, use stamps to cut flowers in the same tone, because my cardstock just doesn't have the same tones. It's always different color tones, and I don't like when it just really doesn't match the tones. So this makes me really happy, because I have all these flowers and embellishments that have exactly the same tones as the rest of the papers have in this collection. And then I also just recently, although by the time this is uploaded, this is probably several months, but I have gotten some stamps. By the time that I'm creating this page, I just recently gotten some stamps, and they had some a French. I didn't even see that when I bought it, but it was just perfect, because this is a day trip in Paris that we did. And so these are some lovely additions. And then this kit came with some like postal stamps, but obviously it's too fiddly for me to cut out these by a fussy cut, and I was too lazy to pull out my silhouette there. So but I have the dies from Tim Holtz, that is one of the chapter 3 die sets that is like an envelope, some kind of die. I forgot the name right now, but I just use, and it comes with, no, there's a postal, like a letter kind of. So I used it comes with two sizes of little stamps, and so I just made sure when I printed out these postal stamp pictures from the collection, that I was printing it out in the size that I would be able to die cut it with those Tim Holtz dies, and it worked out perfectly. So you see in that cluster there is that little, this one, this is a stamp there, and it's in the other cluster there as well. And so again, behind here is one of those French stamps that it has some French writing there, and they're just lovely ephemera that will go on any page, but it just perfectly matches with these French pages from my visits in France. And I've had several visits in France, where I come from, it's not that far away. So for us Europeans, we're used to going to our neighboring countries and stuff like that. So anyway, I have some smaller flowers still that I need to go onto this page, and that I'm dispersing on the different parts of these pages. And I think I just have like a tiny punch. So these are little punch flowers. And again, I'm starting to really work a little more with my with journaling. I've been lazy on my projects with journaling, but so I'm starting to really include some more journaling here. And here's what I stamp the title. And I've been debating whether it was a smart title, Walk the Sites. I know it's not really what, but we were just walking around and looking at the sites, so I just decided to go with this. I always have trouble, especially because my pages are smaller than, and my stamps are not that small, to get titles that actually fit on the page. And so here I just got this also with this, with the same company that sold these French stamps. They had these alpha stamps that are beautiful little scripty alphas, I think. And so I just love the way they turn out. And what I do is I stamp and then I will fussy cut it out. So that's what takes the bulk of the time for this layout, creating this title. So it says Walk the Sites, and one is with uppercase, and then this one I kept with lowercase letters. I guess it's just one single stamp set that comes with uppercase, lowercase letters both. And I think for my projects, it's the perfect size, because I work with smaller projects, not full 12 by 12 scrapbook layouts. So I need stamps that are not so huge and take up the entire page just to stamp one single word. And so this makes me happy that I can use this. And I love scripty stamps. So I always make sure that I clean up my stamps soon after using them, because I don't want the ink to get dried. And then I have a little pair of scissors that's specially meant for cutting delicate designs, and so this makes my life really easy. But I don't really enjoy doing the fussy cutting. I do it sometimes, but I know some people, they really enjoy it, and I just don't try to avoid it where I can. Let's say it this way. So here I'm just running around, and you see me, I'm more or less turning the design. I'm not turning the scissors so much. I'm just moving the design around more. Obviously I wasn't waiting, so I wasn't sure if it had fully dried, so I didn't want to touch this fully. But then there was a lot of touching, obviously, because it's really kind of a fiddly cutting out there. But here I have the first part of the title, and now I have to go with the second part of the title. And I also decided I really wanted to do the fussy cutting, like running it around the letters. And so with this one, I thought it was probably already more dry than the first one, because I had already spent more time on cutting it out than I had spent the time on stamping. So that was giving me extra time to let this dry. And then I always debate how much I should put onto these videos, because obviously there's a lot of preparation that goes on into a page before I even start with the videotaping for these projects. I cut out all the elements that need to go on the page. I cut the flowers, because a lot of the flowers I make myself, I create myself, because I don't have access to just, you know, those flowery things and stuff. And also I don't like when my page gets too bulky, and when I do my own flowers, I can they flatten out a little more again, and so like the pages don't get too bulky. Then if I have a bunch of paper, like actual professionally made paper flowers, that I just never end up using, because I feel like the page will get too bulky with them. And so just haven't found a place to put them yet. I don't even like to put them on the outside of albums because I don't like when the outside of the album is too bulky with elements on the front. So that's where I just enjoy creating my own, and that all these things obviously I have prepared before I ever get to the actual putting together of the page. But then I'm also thinking, well, if like the die cutting, obviously I wouldn't, you know, need to put on video. So in the end, what you get to see here is just the last bit of the preparation of a page and the putting together of a page. It's not at all the entire work. The page obviously starts because for these I use digital papers. I do have actual paper pads and I like using those as well, but with these I start obviously with creating a silhouette. But it doesn't take that long actually to create. That takes me about 10 minutes to create a page and then flip the paper to them, and then it's just printing it out, getting it cut out, and then preparing a page. So yeah, from my old digital scrapbooking days, it still takes longer to create an actual paper page compared to, it would take me about an hour on average to get a normal digital paper page. But here I have finished embellishing everything and I was ready to flip the page around, use the back side of it to then cut the page apart, and this is my page. I'm going to leave you with some more close-ups. I hope you enjoyed this video. Consider giving it the thumbs up, consider subscribing, and I hope you have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye.